Much. I am Eze Onyebuchi, the DG of Society Wellbeing Advocates of Nigeria, Swan. This is the kind of youth we want in this country. She's a lady. She doesn't have money for a university, but that education did not bring her down. My dear, what's your name? Who? Damilola. Where are you from? You're from Lagos State. So you are a painter, right? So can you tell us, how did you start? Why did you decide to go into painting that is not common with women? Why did you decide to go into painting?
At first, I'm a hairstylist.
Okay.
My boyfriend is a painter.
Okay.
So we used to go to sites.
Okay.
So well, just so that I don't decide to go into sites. To just go and see them, but I didn't go to work that day. So as he was doing it, so they asked, I like this today. You see, he told me that even it's not easy, I can't do it. So let me try. So he gave me the lab, he told me more place that I should start from there. But I started it, I only said, he was like, wow, this continues. So I continue from there. So whenever I want to go to science, if I know I'm blessed because I'm not going to work, so I'll follow him with the best business. Just that, this thing is even moving more than my.
Wow.
Let me just surrender myself to paper. Let me follow the site. There are some people that, even though you go to site, they like, give me your number. Because you need a paper, you tell me to give it. At least they call me.
Yes.
I can tell him, since I didn't know how to do all this meditation and all this thing, so I'm calling and telling him, someone call me. So you go there together, you do the meditation, you really want to talk to your friends. So from there, you just start to do it.
So how long have you been painting? Since last year. Wow. So how do you see this work? Is it really helping you put food on your table?
Wow.
Good. So what is your level of education? SSC. You have secondary school certificate. Okay, now, what will be your advice to Nigerian youths? Especially those ones who have certificates, those who did not go to school, who are looking onto government, who have refused to do another thing but cause problems because government have frustrated their lives and refused to help them. What is your advice to Nigerian youths?
Oh, no, it's Nigeria. You have to, if you are thinking about the Nigerian situation, you might need to do something bad. But at least I'll just
My name is Eze Onyebuchi. I'm the DG of Society Wellbeing Advocates of Nigeria, Swan. I ran into a young lady here. She is painting. The lady you see there. And then I granted her an interview. As an organization, we are concerned about Nigerian youths. So we get youths who are not working. We get them trained for free, train them for the kind of skills they want, and then follow them up and make sure they start their skills. And we see a young man like you, and a lady like this doing this work, we decided to interview you and then of course show you to the world, especially Nigerians, who knows. So the lady told me you were her boyfriend, and then she used to follow you to work, and suddenly she started painting, and today she's even equipped and empowered by you. So sir, I want to meet you. What is your name?
My name is Afuayesu Lukman Olamide.
Lukman Olamide. Okay, where are you from?
I'm from Ogun State, Abeokuta.
Ogun State, Abeokuta. What's your level of education?
If you ask, you invest in mass communication.
A mass comm graduate.
I'm a Lukman University.
Okay, when did you start painting?
I started painting since I was in school.
Since you were in school? That means you got equipped, skill, you got empowered from school. Okay, now, why did you decide to go into this painting after graduation instead of waiting for government to come and give you a job?
After seeking for a job for 3-4 years, at least 2015,
actually.
Okay. 4 years. Let's say I naturally know how to paint.
Okay.
So let me just go into it basically and see how it can go far. And presently, I can produce paints.
Wow, can produce paints.
I can produce paints, basically. So I've been going around the multi sites to see if I can get one of these things to do for a living. And maybe it's good, everything is going fine.
And you think, going into this work instead of going to bad things like Yahoo, stealing, this one is better, right?
Yeah, this is more better.
So why did you decide to train your girlfriend on painting? Yeah. Having known that she's a woman.
Yeah, she's actually into she's a hairstylist.
Okay, she's a hairstylist.
I used to like support her whenever she grew hair from she died. So I was like, well, I have interest in this, let me just do it. So from there I learned a lot from her. And when she's less busy, she goes to sell it sometimes. And she already told me, like, let me do this, let me do this. Okay, fine, take drugs, start from here. And I was like, wow, she actually knows things like she's learning.
Wow.
So that was how I actually talked to her on blogs every day. Like, it actually brings a place to her. Sometimes I'll pity her when she's working, like, groundless. And I know she's not tired. Yeah, like, wow, she has more interest in it, even more than the way I have it when I started.
Wow.
Since then, she's been doing well. You can see her. She's not actually working as if she's learning.
So now, what can you say about this kind of woman in a society where ladies don't see themselves doing this kind of work? How can you define this kind of woman?
To me, because maybe she's my girlfriend. Let me say I'm just lucky to meet her. And she's hardworking, she's not this social freak, social media freak at all. Even with challenges up and down, a lot of that work up to her every day, But she's always focused on whatever she wants. She doesn't like, fuck their money, fuck anything. Like what she's saying, she's not paying me for food. Then bring me to God, whatever it is I have, I'm giving it to her. And so I'm just, like, she's supportive. She's very, very supportive. And I'll be okay. And I just pray that she pave way, a better way for her, even at the end of the day. But I pray we settle down together. If God says it's going to happen, I pray God should like help her in other ways.
God bless you. It's my pleasure having an interview with you. You are a great man, and I want you to understand that what you're doing is not better than your certificates. But it's better because you work when you want to work, you are empowered, you are a boss of your own. You go to work when you want to go to work, and you stop when you want to stop. And your certificate, of course, will speak for you one day. So education is not a waste, and I want to also thank you for empowering her and also learning from her. God will bless you, and Swan will also be there. The day of your wedding, we are coming.